Next question is from Servo777. What is the best way to grow forearm size?
Oh, yeah.
Justin, tell them how you did it.
Yeah, just my right arm does. Yeah. Wow. I got a lot of advice for that.
Wow. You know, it's funny. Maybe 2 years ago, two, 3 years ago. So back when we used to be on the YouTube channel, on the Mind Pump YouTube, because we're not really on there that often anymore, but in the beginning it was only...
Back on the YouTuber.
Yeah.
Everyone would say, hey, YouTubers.
Hey, YouTubers.
Hey, what's up out there?
Welcome. I'm your host, Sal Stefano.
I don't know what I'm saying. No, it was Adam, Justin, and myself were on there all the time. We were the only people on there. And I kept saying I wanted to do a video on training forearms. Everybody's laughing at me. Yeah. No, form. Nobody cares about form. I'm like, yes, dude, they are. And I know I've read surveys, and a lot of people are very interested in forearm training. Anyway, it happens to be one of our more popular videos because I think a lot of people are interested in developing strong.
There's a roundabout way of him saying I'm right.
You
know? Just an example.
Another example.
To everybody else's surprise. Yeah. I wasn't surprised. But to their surprise.
All the doubters, you know, sitting next to me.
No, you know, your forearms, you know, represent all the muscles that have to do with your gripping and strengthening your wrist stability. And honestly, every upper body exercise you do involves your hands in some way. And if your hands and your wrists are weak, then you're limited. And oftentimes nowadays, that tends to be the weakest link, where someone can't row as much as they can, or they can't press because their wrists are weak.
And yeah, and before you give all your advice, because you did a really good video about, you know, all the different techniques you can do, we did have a lot of ideas for this in our MAPS OCR program.
Oh, yeah.
And where we actually had, this is where we got to get a little creative because it was so dependent on grip strength and also like barbell or like hanging and doing like climbing and all kinds of stuff because it's obstacle courses. We had some fun with that. And so we added things like the rice bucket. We added some towels in there to grip, to do pull-ups, and did hanging for time. And all kinds of stuff like that are really good for building up forearm strength.
There's some other things that, I mean, when I look back at, like, because I remember being a young kid that was focused on this and doing a lot of like forearm exercises, like direct exercises, and I did not see as much gains in my forearm as I did when I was just doing like heavy loaded things, like heavy carries, mm-hmm. or heavy deadlifts or pull-ups. Like, those exercises put so much demand on grip strength that your forearms they have to build as you progress in that. If you progress in your deadlift and you see that weight go up, mm-hmm. naturally the forearms just come up with that. The same thing when your pull-ups, if you get to a point where you can start to load weight on your body and pull your body weight up, the forearms just naturally grow with that.
Well, that's
just
always been my argument of why I try my best to avoid like wrist wraps and things that there are aids in holding things, because like you do want to be able to build the muscle you know, like up in your back and in your biceps, but you also want to be able to develop other muscles that are supporting cast at the same time. And you know, to really to add like wrist wraps and things like that, a lot of times you create dysfunctions as a result.
Yeah, and if you look at the like different muscles in the body, it starts to become a little clear that some muscles are more suited to stabilize and hold or hold tension, whereas other muscles are more suited to flexing and extending. Okay, so like biceps, pretty good at extending and flexing. The muscles of the forearms, they do that too, but they're really good at static type of stuff. I mean, Adam, you talked about how great, how much you developed your forearms by doing lots of heavy holds.
Yeah.
I mean, the forearm muscles, especially the gripping ones, they're really well suited to do that. So like farmer carries, excellent exercise for the forearms. But also consider this, train different static ranges of motion when you're training your hands. For example, holding a barbell, you may be getting strong in that particular diameter of barbell. Try getting a fatter barbell, wrapping a towel around the barbell, pinching and holding a flat plate. That's a great one where you walk with plates with your fingers in this kind of pinched flat position. That strengthens them differently. Then you could do traditional forearm building exercises like wrist curls. One of my favorite exercises is I put a barbell behind my back, my hands close together, and they're kind of, the back of my hands are resting on my glutes, and then I curl up as far as I can to get the front of the forearm. And then for the other side of the forearm, I like to do reverse curls. One of the best exercises I've ever done for the brachioradialis, and the top of the forearms, and they will develop. They build like any other muscle. You just have to place a little bit of focus on them. And if you're trying to figure out where to put forearm training in your workouts, I like to do them after back or biceps. They seem to pair pretty well with those two areas.